92.5.
So Beauty and the Beast coming to town. We have Brooke, who's here, who plays Belle, and Sam, who is the Beast.
Hey!
Welcome, guys.
Good morning.
Now, when are the shows? They didn't tell us that on the sheet here.
We open tonight. We run through Sunday.
Okay. Real cool. Now, you guys are a part of the traveling show. Yeah. How many different cities have you hit so far?
We are... let me do the math. Philly marks halfway for us.
Okay.
It's a 10-month, 42-week tour.
Wow.
I believe this is venue somewhere in the 40s or 50s. And we're about almost 160 shows in.
Mm-hmm.
So we've seen a few places so far. We started in September, and we're through to July. And we don't hit every state, but it sort of feels like just about every state, maybe minus Alaska and Hawaii.
Mm-hmm.
So...
We're trying to convince them to get us to Hawaii.
At least
still.
Hawaii, right?
But come on.
Nobody ever wants to be convinced to go to Alaska.
You might have to take Alaska to go to Hawaii.
I would do both.
But that's pretty cool.
Fine
so
with it.
Have you guys done tours like this before where it's nationwide and all around? Or?
No, it is.
Both of our first tours.
First national tour for both of us.
Yeah.
Very cool.
Well, how'd you both get into it, Brooke? How did you become Belle?
When
the movie came out, you must have been quite young, right?
I was quite little. I think I was maybe like...
Three-ish? Okay. So either quite little or before little.
No. I was alive. I'm proud to say.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why. Proud moment
Good
for
news.
Me.
Representing the 90s. All right.
Yeah. Anyway, I went to an audition, and there were a lot of girls in blue dresses there,
mm-hmm.
and I sang, and they asked me to sing again. The first time I went in was actually... for the tour last year, and I'd gotten a couple callbacks, but I didn't book the tour. And then last January, I was like, "All right, they're doing it again. I'm gonna do it this year. I'm gonna be Belle."
And
then I did it. but I went through 5 months of callbacks, 11 rounds of callbacks.
Wow!
And then at the end of May, I got a call being like, "You did it," and I was like, "Yeah."
Now, where do they do all this? Where were all the interviews and auditions? Where
New York
are they
City.
All
New York.
New York?
Mm-hmm.
Is that a normal thing? Like 11 callbacks for a part? Is that a normal routine? Or
not always.
Yeah. I mean,
yes and no.
In this particular case, we have had a sister company who just closed on an international tour of this same show. So we had the national company, international company. So it was, you know, casting both of those at the same time.
Ah. So they're pulling us
in
all the time.
A little bit of time to... iron out.
Seeing who
so is it the
where?
Same drill for you, Sam? Were you 11 callbacks?
No, mine was different. I went in for the first time this summer. Everything for me happened in the month of July. So
you're
going to
tell you how good he is now.
Pretty,
I didn't have to come back 11 times. I had to all figure out.
No, I mean, it's so much of this business is
mm-hmm.
timing.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's like, you know, she's... Belle this year for a reason. You know, my first availability being in the city, not outside of the city in a different job, was this summer. And that's all a part of the Disney magic, believe
mm-hmm.
me, that it's this specific group of people on this tour this
right.
year. We, knowing and loving that movie, the stage musical is a little different. We have 6 new songs in the stage version that aren't in the movie that you will feel like you've heard before. The sort of brilliant way that this show is written is the stage version is scored like a movie.
Mm-hmm.
So in a lot of the scenes that is strictly dialogue, there's a lot of the underscore
it.
That you'll be familiar with from the movie. And there are 6 new songs born out of that music.
3 of which are our songs that are not in the movie.
So, you know, it's like 2.0, the Beauty and Beast experience for us getting to play these roles. It's pretty incredible.
Now, do you guys have you're working for Disney, which is amazing. That's probably one of the best companies in the world to work for. Do they kind of monitor, like in our business, we're constantly being raided. Is there somebody every now and then going to your show and saying, listen there, Belle, you need to step this part up a little more. Do you get like someone who sits there and like a consultant or something that travels with you guys?
Our stage manager, she keeps the show true to what it should be, and she'll watch it sometimes from the audience and take notes on it and be like, hey, this is happening here, we just want to see what's going on. And this week we actually are almost all of our Disney creative team will be here,
mm-hmm.
And so we like brush up and clean up things every like
couple of months
and a half, 2 months ish, which is nice because it keeps everything fresh for you.
Right.
When you're doing something on repeat, you don't ever want it to look like it's on repeat. You want it to be fresh and exciting for every single audience.
That was always something, you know, I noticed with musical artists, you know, I always ask, do you ever get tired or bored? And they're like, well, no, actually,
it's
the audience reaction.
Every night.
It's,
even though you're doing the same thing every night, you're playing off the audience and the adrenaline you're getting from the audience. Just
you're going. It's always someone's first show. And that's like, you can never get into a place that you're like, oh, I'm bored, because it's someone's first show. It's their first experience. And you always want to give your best for them, for everyone.
We're hitting all of these major cities. This is the sixth year that this particular tour has been out. And it's what makes it so special is, again, this group of people and this year. You know, if you've seen the show before, you're going to love it in a new way.
Right.
And if you've never have,
so there's new things for people who haven't seen it before. You're going to see new things each time. Bring it in.
Yeah.
What's the age group you pull from? Is it mainly parents and kids, or is it now because of the age of the movie?
Right. It would surprise you. Everyone. You would think just parents and kids, or, you know, like daycare programs or something. But we have we've noticed these groups of millennials and on coming by themselves. You know, it's a date night movie. It is a grandparent down to grandchild movie.
Right. It's very mass appeal.
Musical, rather. It is. I think it hits everybody.
And shockingly enough, there's like a middle school, high school age bracket that these kids love this show. And it's cool because it was after their time for sure. And like kind of a little before when their parents would have been having kids. So it's like people that you didn't think would even really acknowledge that kind of movie. Love it. I have a lot of Instagram followers in that age bracket.
So how many people actually are on like the touring cast altogether?
We have 30 in the cast.
Okay.
And we travel with our own crew and our own orchestra. So I want to say there's close to 50 altogether.
Yeah.
So that's got to be pretty cool. Like you said, you got to play in your hometown pretty much. It's got to be pretty cool. Anytime somebody goes home, they're like, got to go to wherever the place is to eat or do all those sorts of things. That's got to be, you got 50 people. You're pretty much seeing a good amount of the country.
Yeah. One of our boys in the ensemble, Kevin Culp, is a hometown hero here in Philly. So he's very excited to be home and playing for a home audience. And I mean, it just adds a whole new level.
You got to make sure
Kevin. It's like a good energy.
Oh, I believe it. You got to make sure Kevin takes you to the right places, though.
Yeah.
I expect a full report on what Kevin has done with you guys while you're here.
Deal.
Make no sure McDonald's, you got the city. No Wendy's.
Yeah. No, we try to avoid that. We're trying to get the culture each place.
Very cool.
You can get some of that here while you're here, too.
Plenty of culture here. They'll give it to you if you
but
want.
But it's
it.
Got to be cool. I mean, you're getting to discover America on Disney's dime, you know? Pretty much. So, no, that's nice. So give us again the dates. Starts tonight.
Starts tonight, goes through Sunday.
Okay.
There are two shows Saturday and two shows Sunday. Come check us out.
All right. Well, thanks for coming in, guys.
Thanks
we appreciate
us.
It.
You guys.
Yay. Yay. Yay.